pretty chippy game, Parker, would you say?
Yeah. Obviously, they prepared. They had a 9-day layoff, and they came in here ready to play. And, you know, historically, they have always played physical, and that was their game plan, and I thought we did a good job.
Jason, when Aiden went out with a couple fouls, did you put more emphasis on yourself to kind of factor into the game more?
Yeah, I mean, obviously somebody had to step up when he made the second foul in the first half. And, you know, that was me. I mean, we are a deep team. So we have a lot of pieces that, you know, when this happens, there's somebody else going to step up. So I was just the guy tonight, and that's pretty much it.
How much of Alonzo did we get tonight? How limited was he?
I wouldn't say he was limited. I mean, let me see his stats.
He played fine, but as far as, you know, the normal that you see day to day with him when he doesn't have like a knee injury or something.
Yeah, I mean
probably would you say the knee injury like affected him a little bit?
Yeah, I mean, you know, I think it was more mental than anything.
Yeah.
I thought he made the plays we needed him to make down the stretch. He was our leader, like he is every night. So we have a couple days off here. He'll get better each day.
Even in a bad game, he scores 15 points. So we'll take that.
Was this one of your better games? Do something. Regardless of the stats, because I think you had 20-10 at one point. Mm-hmm. You know, 18 and whatever is 10 against a pretty good team.
Yeah, it was. I mean, obviously important for performance for us, for the whole team. Because DeAndre, obviously, in the first half, he didn't play that much. And, you know, I just try to help this team. You know, obviously, I think we played pretty well in the first half. Then in the beginning of the second half, they made a little run. And it was a pretty close game until last 6 minutes. And, you know, I just kept playing hard, and that's it. Nothing special.
Miller talked to you about you playing really well last game. Are you kind of finding your niche or whatever you want?
I'm just trying to help this team, you know, win as many games as we can. I'm trying to like raise my defense to like another level. Trying to do a better job defending the ball screens, defending the post players, rebounding better, just overall becoming a better player. That's it.
Roshan, you're pretty, you know, you're calm on the court most of the time. And tonight there was a little bit of a fire with you playing. Is there anything in particular that kind of helped that?
Not really. Maybe in some moments the game fell that way. That's why I felt a little fire. But like I said, it was just. I just did what I do usually in practice and everything.
What's it been like in general, just on this, your career? It seems like you've added a little bit as you've been here, gotten better in a lot of areas. And you had like this year, like last year, Lowry comes in and he does his thing. And this year you got DeAndre and everybody's talking about him. I mean, is that good maybe to play in that shadows or is it frustrating?
Yeah. I mean, obviously I had that, you know, opportunity to play with great players, especially my position here in Arizona. In all 4 years, even my first 2 years, I had Caleb, and last year Lowry, this year DeAndre. They're great players, and I think I learned a lot from them as well. So, you know, like you said, maybe they talk more about DeAndre, but on the other side, on the other hand, that helps me too. You know, just practicing every day against DeAndre, going against him every day in practice is a thing that not a lot of players, you know, get to do. Obviously, he's, you know, one of a kind. He's an unbelievable player, and you know, I'm just happy to have the privilege to play against him every day.
Parker, do you think the three-point shooting as a team is starting to come around? You guys had a little run there early in the second half where it seemed like those are the only shots you guys were making, not inside and hitting those. Is there something you're doing differently?
Yeah, I think we're just getting the reps up. I mean, every day in practice, at the beginning or the end, you know, we're shooting 300 shots, getting our reps in. We have a lot of guys on this roster that can shoot the three, that can shoot from really anywhere on the floor, including our bigs. So, you know, we have a lot of confident guys that when we're open from three, you know, we look to take those and make them.
Parker, you rate-wise, no issues hitting the three. You know, you're above 40%. As far as what would need to happen in a game for you to take like a whole bunch of them, because it looks like there are times where, you know, there's a difference between when you take one and when you don't take one. What's your thought process?
I think I've just always tried to take good ones rather than just, you know, just jacking them or taking ones that I don't feel comfortable with. You know, coach believes in me, my teammates believe in me to take threes. But I know for myself that the rhythm that I get comes from taking good ones. So, you know, when I'm open, you know, I'll shoot it and you know, if they, you know, disrespect me going to a screen, I'll take one. But I just think my rhythm starts with starting when I'm open and taking a goal.
Does it affect you at all when for better or worse, when the game is tied like it was and you hit that three in the corner? I mean, you know, is the score a factor at all? Or just, you know, making a difference kind of thing? Does that add anything to your
not really.
Like any other, that situation?
Yeah, I mean, I just credit my teammates for just finding me, really. DeAndre found me on a great out of the post pass, and Dusan found me in previous games. So I mean, I credit my teammates for really finding me, and you know, I just want to make it.
What are you seeing out of Raleigh? He's coming 20 points tonight, kind of quietly but nice. Is he kind of progressing? If you think he's better?
Well, it's not surprising. I mean, it's just a testament to how hard he works. You know, when he got hurt, you know, he just chips away every day at his recovery, and his work ethic is at an all-time high. And, you know, the guy just wants to win. You know, when he's out there playing with confidence and doing the things that we know he can do, it really helps our team and takes us to another level.
To kind of piggyback off what Bruce asked you, when you're, you know, in the rhythm, you're about to catch the pass, you're ready to take a three, are you thinking about, like, this will get us the lead as you're getting into your rhythm to shoot?
Not necessarily. It's just, you know, I've got to get my feet set, make sure I'm ready to shoot the ball, because I know, you know, when they are getting trapped, you know, we are swinging the ball, getting good ball movement. You know, when it hits me, most of the time I am open. And so I just try to be as ready as possible and let it go.
What was the difference? You guys, it was pretty deep, you know, pretty good defense early lower, you know, and some shots from Mister in the first half, and then all of a sudden the second bowl team shot like 60% for the first 8-10 minutes. Would you see any difference out there one way or another why that was, the game changing so drastically?
Well, first off, give them credit. I mean, they didn't quit. They fought the whole game from start to finish. And they made runs, and, you know, they have big-time players on their team that made shots. So, and we have big-time players on our team that make shots. I just think it was a hard-fought battle, and, you know, we both wanted to win the game. I thought we may play more plays at the end, and came out with a hard-fought W.
Dusan, when you and DeAndre are on the court at the same time, I know a lot of teams have kind of gone smaller. You guys have 2 7-footers out there. What kind of advantage do you think that gives you guys, having that kind of height advantage? And, you know, what is it like for you to play with another 7-footer and a guy like DeAndre?
I mean, it's all about how we approach those teams. Obviously, mm-hmm. Tonight we played against a team that kind of played with two bigs as well. So I think we use it pretty well. But in some other games, when they play small, you know, we have to, the part of the thing that we do in practice is just get comfortable, you know, guarding those small ball teams. And I think, like, after Bahamas, I think we had a lot of success in doing that. You know, obviously Bahamas wasn't perfect, but after we came back and we had a position in practice, and we're just working hard in that area every day, you know, just defending ball screens, especially DeAndre, as you saw today. He was in a few situations when he switched on a guard, and I think he did a great job. And that just tells you how versatile he is, DeAndre. So I think we're getting, from this point on, we just improved the day.
Just like coming into the game, 2 hours before the game, you're out there warming up, going through your drills and stuff. Did you anticipate them double and triple teaming DeAndre and know that was going to give you some opportunities to really do some damage on the offensive end?
I mean, that's what we expect pretty much every game. They're going to trap either me or DeAndre or both of us. And, you know, I just did my drills that I do before every game. I didn't do anything new before this game. I just did what I do every day, every game.
You seem like you were a lot more aggressive, especially in the second half, and even kind of giving the business a little bit to the guy right before timeout. But what was the situation there, and did you feel more aggressive tonight?
That's something that Coach challenged me with that a few weeks ago, and it's something that I'm trying to improve. Obviously, like I said earlier, trying to become a better defensive player, try to rebound better, just playing better game overall. You know, I'm just trying to impact this team, to give this team not just one thing, but like a lot of different things, and that's what I'm trying to do.
How would you guys characterize overall the non-conference season? Or you know that you're done 10-3?
I mean, I would say it was pretty successful, except the Bahamas trip. That was our shortcoming this year. It was a really, really tough time, but I think we bounced back well after those three games.
Go ahead.
Well, I was wondering, do you look at the Bahamas as like a one-off, like, hey, this was just weird what happened there, or was it something you kind of grew from?
I mean, we're still, after the tournament, we were trying to figure out what went wrong in the Bahamas, you know. And obviously, we changed some teams, and after that, we won, what, 7 games in a row. I think we're in a good track to play our best basketball in February, March. So, and to answer your first question, I think our non-conference schedule is pretty tough this year. We play a lot of good teams, and that's going to help us long term. That's going to help us in Pac-12, later on Pac-12 tournament, and March Madness.
Parker, was there one, just to follow up on that, was there one thing, or maybe a couple of things really between, after the Bahamas, since then that's really changed, that's helped you guys? Would you say that you've kind of worked on it?
I think, yeah, Bahamas was probably a blessing in disguise, just in, you know, the fact that we played some good teams, and you know, I thought we fought hard in the Bahamas and came up short. And since then, we've you know, drastically got better on defense, and you know, really took into account what coaches tell us each day, just try to get better. And I think it's going to help us, like Dusan said, in the later months as we get later, deeper in our season. And I think going into the break, you know, we're really excited about what's to come.